coaches are going to tell you this week. You got all sorts of distractions. It's summertime. All sorts of distractions. You have that your whole life. Every day before practice, you're coming with more and more reasons to not go. As you get older, you're going to use your friends, and then you're always going to go, oh, I have homework, and I have a T-ball. You're always going to have these excuses. You either do it or you don't. You either show up or you don't. Now, I'll ask you guys, be real honest. You don't have to raise your hand, but answer this to yourselves. How many of you before practice today were thinking a little bit, I don't really want to go? You have to raise your hand, but it's real, right? What did you think about that summer? Thank you. Honest man. Yeah, it's fair. It's fair. Summertime, your friends are out doing something, maybe they're staying up late, maybe they're sleeping in later. It's just life. It's just real life. It's never going to go away. It's not because of your age. Young guys up to the older guys. But I want to ask you another question right now. Now that practice is done, right now, honest answer, does anybody regret coming? That's the trainer. Never. Never, ever in your life will you go do a workout and think, oh, I wish I had done that. You never walk into these doors, walk onto one of these mats, and not leave a little bit stronger, burn up a few calories, leave a little bit faster, learn a new technique, visit with somebody. Never. That's the trade-off. You have to get in the car before practice so that you can feel the way you do now. Once the hard work's done and it's behind you. I just want you guys to remember that because you're learning a lesson. Guys, in wrestling, I want to share just with my experience with you. A couple things really fast. But first off, we talked about it earlier. What does wrestle mean?
Move.
Thank you. It just means to move. You're going to hear that. You're going to have your dads yelling at you. You're going to have your coaches yelling at you. You're going to be in positions. Positions where a coach is going to be yelling, wrestle, wrestle, wrestle. You're going to be thinking to yourself, hey, give me a little more advice. Grab the right leg, grab the left leg, pick the right leg back, move the left leg. He's just going to yell, wrestle. What that coach is telling you to do is to move. We talk about who wrestles harder than who. We're talking about who moved more than who. That's what wrestling means. And you guys are going to know this, but wrestling is a sport of tough people. Tough men and tough women. You're going to hear that too. Your dads are going to tell you. Your moms are going to tell you. Your coaches are going to tell you. You got to be tough. You got to be a tough guy. And you'll buy in. You'll think, I want to be a tough guy. I want to do that. What's that mean? That's another one of those tricky terms, isn't it? What does that mean? Do I have to be a champion? Do I have to have trophies? Do I have to have medals? Or do I have to be a jerk? Does that mean I'd be a bull? What does that mean to be a tough guy? I'll tell you what a tough guy is. A tough guy goes hard the whole time no matter what the score is. That is the definition of a tough guy. In your wrestling careers, when you're sitting back in the stands and you're watching someone on the mat, it's somebody you admire and somebody you look up to. I promise you, it'll be somebody who goes hard the whole time no matter what the score is. If they are ahead by 10 points and there's 10 seconds left, they are going hard. If they are behind by 10 points and there's 10 seconds left, they're going hard. They are trying to score on the other guy. They are preventing from their opponent scoring or trying to do so with an effort. That's what a tough guy is. It's not a champion. It's not the big muscles. It's right here. A tough guy will go hard the whole time no matter what the score is. That's what the goal of the sport is. I have to tell you guys something. I have to tell you something about your coach, Coach Robertson. Coach Roberts and I were roommates. Coach Roberts would probably tell you we were friends, but it made it very hard for me to be his friend because he was somebody I looked up to. And that changes things. When you look up to a guy, it changes things. He was just before me in school. He won everything you could win. He was in every publication they printed. He's the top-ranked wrestler in the country. He's a little bit older than me. You guys know what that's like. So you look up to a guy. I will tell you something he did that affected my life, and I don't just mean that as a wrestler, I mean as a human being. His senior year, top-ranked wrestler in the country, 2 weeks before the national tournament, which will constitute his last competitive match of his life, he did something to his ankle. And I would tell you what he did, but I swear to you, I don't know, and it was 21 years ago. He either broke it, or he tore it, or he did a combination of the two, but in 20 years, he's never told me. And he's never told anybody else, and he never used it as an excuse. He entered that tournament. He did the best that he could do. He made weight because that, as he saw it, was his obligation when anybody else would have stepped aside. And 21 years later, I do not know what was wrong with his ankle. 21 years later, he never used it as an excuse, and he never said, poor me, ever. That didn't just affect me as an athlete. That's one of the reasons I look up. But guys, that's what we do as wrestlers. That's what we do. Wrestling is very straightforward. There will be three rounds with a referee, and when it's done, we'll look at the scoreboard, and whoever has more points will get their hand raised, and that's it, and we shake hands and we walk away. We shake hands and we walk away. If we have a dispute, we settle it here, and we shake hands and we walk away. That's what makes wrestlers different. And there will be some days where you will have something wrong. You could be sick, you could be distracted. You could have a broken and torn ankle and have to keep the secret for 21 years, even from your closest friends. But it goes the other way as well. If we're being real fair, there are days when we will come onto this mat, and after three rounds, we'll look up and we'll have more points than another guy who had some ailment. And we're going to feel good about our win. We're going to feel good about advancing. He gets to feel good if he gets over on us. But it's very straightforward. Very straightforward. And little kids wrestling, some of you young guys, they'll separate you by a couple of years. If you get into high school, they'll separate you by 4 years. Just freshman through senior thing. They do that in college. And I don't know a darn thing about it. Somebody wants to wrestle, I want to wrestle too. You got your shoes and I got my shoes. You weigh us in if you want to, or we can just step on the line. I don't know anything about it. Tough guys are going to go hard the whole time, no matter what the score is. Wrestlers move. Pretty straightforward, isn't it? We know about hard work. We know about dedication. I will hear coaches, and you guys are going to be told, for the rest of your careers, you have to want it. And you have to have desire, and you have to feel it in your stomach. As a coach, I resist telling guys that. I resist it because it's not a switch I can kick on. I can't make myself want something. There's been a lot of times in my life where I was motivated, and I did want it, and I had that desire, but there was never a time where I could flip that switch. It was like being happy, or being sad, or being excited, or being scared. It was just the human emotions that I couldn't control. But I do know about discipline. I do know, for me, practice started at 5:30, which meant I had to be in the car by 5, whether I felt like it or not. And whether you feel like it or not, we as your coaches will expect you to have more points than the other guy when time runs out. And if you take a headbutt, you're not feeling good, we as your coaches will expect you to have more points than the other guy when time runs out. And that can come down to discipline. And that's a very important thing that you're going to need for the rest of your life. A lot of your parents do not love what they have to do every day when that alarm clock goes off. But they get up and they put their boots on and they go do it anyway. They don't always have a motivation and a love and desire for what they do. But when that alarm clock goes off, you get up and you put your boots on and you go do it anyway. Want to know what happens if you have a good day when you're an adult? You put your boots on and you go to work. You know what happens if you have a bad day as an adult? You put your boots on and you go to work. It's about discipline. To be a motivated athlete, boy, life's easy when you're motivated. You want to do it. But it's not always a switch of discipline. When you have a desire and a goal and a dream, life's easy. It's easy. You're looking forward to practice coming around. You're looking forward to getting on the mat and grabbing another guy. I just don't think it's something you can control. But you can be disciplined. The same thing comes down to a wrestling man. I got to get to his leg more time than he gets to mine. I got to get on his head. I got to clear him off of mine. I got to know where the out of bounds is. I got to hustle back to the center. They're just little disciplined things. And those little tiny battles, 1 second here and 1 second there, adds up to a round. And those rounds add up to matches. And those matches add up to tournaments. And those tournaments end up to championships. And those championships turn into titles. And that turns into your career, and that turns into your life, and that's that. For me, I believe it comes to discipline. I believe that's something you all have. Right here in the summertime, showing up into this room, I think that comes to discipline, guys. I think you have it. I think you're going to hear your whole life about people that need it, want it. You might use some of you will even sit back and say, wow, what's that like? It's you. We're talking about you. You hear about these hard workers out there. We're talking about you. You are the hard workers. Talking about men and women with goals and dreams. Who are we talking about? We're talking about you. We're talking about tough guys that will go hard the whole time, no matter what the score is. We're talking about you. We're talking about you. Make sure you reward yourself. Make sure you feel good about yourself. Make sure you thank your parents. Make sure you thank your coaches. And I thank all of you for letting me be here today. Coach?
Wow. I do not know how to follow that up, first of all. One more. Now. do real quick is we're going to get the little guys in the front right here. When I say go, we're going to get the big guys right in the back of this gray mat, the medium guys, Barnes, you're in the back. We're going to squeeze together so Zeb can take our picture, and we're going to pick up all our stuff, all the staff, and hopefully I have enough. I won't eat if I don't for the parents. I got some pizzas down here. And then you guys can thank Chael and shake his hand as he gets out of here. Okay, he's a busy guy. He has about 17 jobs. He has a pretty wife down there, a couple little kids, and he took it out of his time to come down here and work with us. So I can't thank him enough for that. So we're gonna get a photo while he's here, and then we're gonna break. Okay, and we're gonna be back at 6 o'clock. And try to keep the momentum up that we just had this practice. All right, on two, picture time. Ready? One, two, let's go.